Set. This is the Fade stream. It's the music like stream, music like thing here. You also have dots here, which, as you can see, the Fade stream is moving. The skull and crossbones are things you want to try and get rid of as fast as possible, because if they reach the end of the screen, they will deal damage to your heroes. At this point in the game, though, they won't deal much damage to you. As you might be seeing, I'm doing combos. Combos are initiated when you use more than one color of a striker, or if you have the same color striker like that there later on. That also helps increase the combo. Each this you have 30 you have tw 24 fights you have to get through, and the goal is to get through them as quickly as possible using large amounts of chains and combos to do that. And one other thing I did not mention in the intro is that this game, or this difficulty in particular, it's not guaranteed that I'm going to finish. There's about a 5% chance, 5 to 10% chance that this will not finish. It all depends on the very first boss, which we will get to shortly. And also depends on which enemies I get as well. Because every single fight you have specifically one, there's one, you have a couple of different enemies you can get, and one of them tends to be much harder than the rest. When you get all four heroes in on the same attack, sometimes you'll get a full animation which shows the portraits of all of the characters. Otherwise, it'll show up when we get into Super Strikers, which we'll get into later on. In terms of this screen, we do not want to miss any level ups, because the more level ups you get, the higher your hero levels, the more damage you do. In terms of this difficulty in general, there's a lot of differences. One is there's less level ups per level that you can get. There are more health, stronger attacks, you know, the more attacks, just the whole shebang. And right here is one of the enemies that is a little tricky. But you can do things like that to minimize the amount of damage you can take. These are armored enemy strikers. They take two hits to destroy. And there's the full screen animation, like I was saying. Another thing I forgot to mention is that this game is run in not run in real time. It's run in game time. But we do still include real time times in on at the end of the run. So far, these enemies have been easy, but starting fairly shortly, we're going to get into some enemies that are going to be starting to get more dangerous, and they're just going to continue to get more and more dangerous from here on out. And it's especially the last 7 or 8 enemies that are going to be the ones that are going to deal the most. They're going to be the most troublesome. So now the gray strikers that you chargers that you see are enemy chargers, and they do what they say. They increase your enemies' attacks from their own chargers. So again, they're things you want to get rid of as quickly as possible. We also have enemy hexes, and we go straight to ones that are actually armored. Normally, things don't go this quickly. One thing I should mention is that if you get hit by an attack, whether it's from an opponent or not an opponent, that it clears the entire row of all everything of all of your attacks and everything. So that's one reason why you do not want to get hit, or try not to get hit. There are some points where it's nearly impossible to get to avoid getting hit. Ooh, this is an interesting. That was interesting there. One thing I want, another thing I want to point out is the composer of this, composer of the soundtrack you're listening to right now is Sam English. As I was stating before the run, I think it's an extremely good. It's extremely good for indie soundtrack, like extremely good. And you'll hear my favorite track later at the very end of the game. Another thing I should probably mention is that every enemy has its own HP value. So if I were running this game for world record attempts, I would reset until I got one that would guarantee a fast fight, and this one is not a fast fight. That took quite a bit longer than it normally should have. One thing is, you might notice me trying to grab things and it doesn't grab. That's because, surprisingly, this is a port of a mobile game. They ported a mobile game to the computer. I mean, that's the only down. They got everything else about this right, except for that. Here is the introduction of squares. Square things cannot be moved. That's literally it. All you need to know about that. But right about here is when the game starts to get pretty serious. Especially when they start throwing this kind of crap at me. Normally, you're probably supposed to use a skill to get rid of that, but I don't really care. I'm fast enough that I can actually clear everything out without needing to use a skill, which we will talk about when it becomes relevant. But the thing I've noticed is that if they have a lot more attacks, if they send more attacks, they have less HP. Like, as you saw, that guy had very little HP. But pretty soon we are going to get into the first gatekeeper of the run, which is the first boss. Depending upon the first who the first boss is, it could be very hard or very easy. If I get the T-Rex looking enemy, that's going to be very difficult. If I get any other enemy, it's going to be very easy. Here, you're gonna start to get things that take 3 hits to destroy. So right now you're seeing there are things that are taking 3 hits to destroy now instead of 2. The other thing you might notice is that every enemy has its own speed that it. Of the phase stream, every phase stream speed is different. It's based on which enemy you're fighting. But another thing to mention is that there are some enemies that make it very easy to get chains, which are or combos or chains, whatever you want to call them. They're the it's the decimal that appears after you've. Take care of an enemy. Ooh, that was a bit of a difficult there. Like so normally when I'm at this point everyone should be level 21, but as you can see, hard mode nerfs some of the removes some of the levels you can get. This is also when we start to get some very devious patterns with what you get on the phase stream. Like, this is a pretty devious pattern. It's, you're going to see it more than once, for sure. That right there is the Super Striker. That normally deals a lot more damage, but I didn't really have another option. I had to use it immediately. That deals a lot more damage if you're able to get other hero strikers on the field. One thing I'm not going to be able to tell you is what all of the hexes do. There's just too many hexes, and this run is relatively short. So I'm not going to be able to explain what all of them do, but I will explain what some of the more dangerous ones do. This one right here is not dangerous at all. So you don't need to worry about it too much. Another thing is, if you're able to get rid of more than one attack at once, you should do that. Especially on this difficulty, because this difficulty is very, very hard. Also, as time goes on, the enemy will start sending more and more attacks at you until you hit a kill screen where they send so many attacks you're not able to deal with them. You're literally just not able to deal with all of them. And death in this game is very bad because you basically lose the run you're on. Thankfully, I finished the last four runs that I've finished that I've done. Anyways, this is gonna be a first boss, and this is gonna be the hard boss, so I'm gonna need some quiet time for this. Okay, so I'm using slow skill here. It does what it says, slows down the slows everything down for you. Since this is a speedrun, you don't want to use it, but if you have to, use it. Because it can save your ass, like you just saw. That's a heal ability. Pretty self-explanatory. Holy shit. That was really close. That is that guy for you. Holy shit. I do not know how I saved that. But that was a good save. Now the rest of the run should be good. Hopefully. Right now, what you're seeing is first introduction of colored enemy strikers. They have to be hit with that specific color. Can you lay off me for one sec, dudes? Okay, we're back into the swing of things now. Okay, so like I said, if you die, all four of your characters die, you instantly have to start a new run, and that was the one point where I added some safety into the run. In case I died there, I added enough time for me to be able to start another run at that point. If I die at any point after this, this run will not finish because I will not have enough time to finish the run. But like I said, that should not happen. Any lag you're seeing at the during combos is actually the game and not the stream. Okay. Also, when after a character dies, they lose all their abilities, and that's pretty much the major thing that happens. Thankfully, you get them back after a certain period of time, and that was not a very good level up sequence. I missed like 4 or 5 levels there, which means that the later fights are going to be harder. I will mention this hex. I believe this hex is armor. Armor pierce, which basically means you take more damage, a lot more damage. This guy also seems to like to send a lot of attacks, which means he probably doesn't have a lot of health. But he's hanging on, so he might have a good bit of health. Whenever you see cracks in all the enemy stuff, it means that they are close to dead. Relatively close to dead. Okay, so the main, we want to get the red guy, the fighter, as many levels as possible, because he's going to be the main damage dealer. If you notice a little freeze after some of my attacks, that is because whenever you have another of the same color hex in the, or a same color charger that hero attack is, it'll freeze the screen for a second, and that's something that we take heavy advantage of in this difficulty. Another thing that should be mentioned is what you might have seen there, superchargers do damage based upon which hero strikers are currently on the field. So if all four color strikers are on the field, then you'll get a four attack. Didn't get that one in time. This fight isn't nearly as scary as the previous dinosaur. He's smaller. He still has quite a bit of health though. And in case you're just joining, you can move anything that is not a square. Anything that is a square cannot be moved, regardless of if it's an enemy or your own attacks. Okay, I was starting to get a little dicey. And right around here is where I'm not going to be able to talk as much, because this is where things start to get fairly crazy. There's going to be one new thing that's going to get added, and that's going to be enemy strikers in hero chargers. It's basically a skull and crossbones in one of the hero chargers. And you should see it relatively soon. Other than that, right here. Other than that, I'm probably not gonna be able to talk nearly as much anymore, because this is where the game starts to pick up. So if you have any donations for now, you can read them.
Unfortunately, we do not have any donations right now. You can donate using the link in chat. Any donations go directly to the Tremor Project. They all are greatly appreciated. Thank you.
Okay. So we haven't seen any of the really scary hexes yet. Some should start appearing very soon. I'll explain them right now. One is basically a bomb. What it does is it fills the entire row. When it hits this white circle here, it fills that entire row with enemy stuff. And it's really, really nasty, really bad. You don't want to get it. I'll let it get to the end of the screen. Another one is the freeze charm, which you should see fairly soon. Another one is this one up here that is lifesteal. Basically, every single time you get it's damage over time, basically. And you get damaged over time with it. And it also depends on what level you're on, because higher level you're on, the more damage he's gonna life steal. Okay, I'm gonna heal that right now. Heal also removes hexes, and it gets rid of everything on the screen, so it's a good thing to do at that juncture. Sometimes enemies go into these kinds of lulls in attacks where they just do like nothing. They send hardly anything your way. That's completely normal. And it happens occasionally. Anyways, second boss is coming up soon. Most of them are easy. I haven't seen any that are particularly difficult. But might as well just be silent for this boss as well, because it's another gatekeeper, and if I die, then that's the run, basically. It's gonna be right after this fight. One thing I did not mention is if you get the square enemy chargers, you want to focus those guys down as quickly as possible, because you're not able to move them, therefore you're not able to delay their attack, therefore bad things happen. There's another hex that's really bad. It is the fast forward hex, and it does what it says. It basically makes the fate stream move a lot faster. And when you're playing on this difficulty, moving a lot faster usually means you're dead. And when I say you're dead, I literally mean you're dead. There's literally nothing you can do except counteract with slow. And even doing that is not a guarantee that you're going to survive. This guy also seems to have a lot of HP, which is not good. Basically, you can think of the gray chart, the gray chargers, as like roadblocks. Like they tend to block a lot of what you want to do. Okay, next is boss 2. Hopefully it gives me a good one, otherwise I might be screwed. But I have faith in this game's RNG. Good news is I haven't missed a single level up since that disastrous 4 or 5 level up I missed. But here's boss. This one's fairly easy if I remember right. Oh yeah, this one's pretty easy already. The reason why I'm saying it's easy is because it's giving me a lot of opportunities to attack. Like, a lot. It might switch out of that phase into one where it gives me a lot fewer opportunities to attack, but it does not look like this one's going to. So this should be a fairly easy fight. You can also trigger a super striker with another of your own strikers. That's actually something I did not know until very recently. That's fine. It's fine if I take an attack or two. This enemy isn't that dangerous. Buddy's almost dead, so just like one more big chain should finish it off. There you go, that's second boss. And now if the last boss is not a total dick like he was yesterday, when I did a practice run of this, this run should be in the bag. It should finish without any issues. Right now I kind of wish that my the guy with the sword, is a bit higher level. But right, starting now is when I'm not going to be able to talk at all. Like, at all. did not want to have to use this, just click on a striker and it changes it into one of your own strikers. You click on any of your charges and it changes it into a striker of your own. That's one I kind of wanted to save for the last boss, but this necessity, I was about to take a lot of damage, so necessity meant that I had to use it. Amazingly, one of the achievements you can get in this game is to beat the game without using a single skill. And that is plausible on this difficulty, it's just very fucking hard. I have not gotten it myself. If you have any donations or you have anything you want to plug, go ahead and do that now.
No donations currently, but once more, you can donate. In fact, through the link that will post in the chat, any and all donations go directly to the Trevor Project, which is a fantastic cause, so thank you all very much.
So all of the fighter skills are timed. With the white, basically the white things. But if you just spam the button, I found you can just hit everything. Or near all of them perfectly. Again, that's another skill I wish I didn't have to use, but I was pretty much about to get my ass kicked once again. So I decided to go ahead and use that. Hopefully I'll have at least Heroes, Fighters special meter back up to at least 2 or 3. Second or third ability by the end of this. Anyways, this is going to be where you're going to see the freeze charm. As well as other charms, hexes, but I don't really know what all, off the top of my hand, what all of them do because I don't get hit by them very often. Wow. Okay, so this just got a hell of a lot scarier. Okay, now I'm absolutely gonna need silence for the rest of this fight. Hopefully I can survive it. I should have used the other one. Fuck. The other one is a healing spell. I should have used that one. And that's going to be the run. You can just end the time. So, sorry I wasn't able to finish it for you guys, but I just don't know what happened. I made a major mistake at the end. I should have resurrected instead of shielding, and yeah. But if this game looked fun to you, there is a speedrun.com page for it. And if you're interested in learning it, you can hit me up on the Puzzle Discord, Puzzle General Discord, or you can private message me in chat. I'd like to thank SS4C for allowing me to do these two runs for you, and if you liked what you saw, go to twitch.tv/raiseflamecon and give me a follow. Thanks again for having me, and I will see you guys next time.